This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Henry Cabot Lodge Jr. July 5, 1902 to February 27, 1985, sometimes referred to as Henry Cabot Lodge II, was a Republican United States Senator from Massachusetts and a U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations, South Vietnam, West Germany, and the Holy See as presidential representative. He was the Republican nominee for vice president in the 1960 presidential election. Contents: 1. Early life. 2. Political career. 21. First U.S. Senate career. 22. World War II. 23. Return to Senate and the drafting of Eisenhower. 24. Ambassador to United Nations. 25. 1960 Vice Presidential Campaign. 26. Ambassador to South Vietnam. 27. Walking for President. 28. Later career. 3. Personal life. 4. See also. 5. References. 6. External links. Early life. Lodge was born in Nahant, Massachusetts. His father was George Cabot Lodge, a poet, through whom he was a grandson of Senator Henry Cabot Lodge, great-great-grandson of Senator Elijah H. Mills, and great-great-great-grandson of Senator George Cabot through his mother, Mathilda Elizabeth Frelinghuysen Davis. He was a great-grandson of Senator Frederick Theodore Frelinghuysen, and a great-great-grandson of Senator John Davis. He had 2 siblings, John Davis Lodge 1903-1985, also a politician, and Helena Lodge Destriel B. 1905. Lodge attended St. Albans School and graduated from Middlesex School in 1924. He graduated cum laude from Harvard University, where he was a member of the Hasty Pudding and the Fox Club. Political career. Lodge worked in the newspaper business from 1924 to 1931. He was elected in 1932, and served in the Massachusetts House of Representatives 1933 to 1936. First U.S. Senate career. In November 1936, Lodge was elected to the United States Senate as a Republican, defeating Democrat James Michael Curley. He served from January 1937 to February 1944. World War II. Lodge served with distinction during the war, rising to the rank of lieutenant colonel during the war. He saw 2 tours of duty. The first was in 1942 while he was also serving as a U.S. Senator. The second was in 1944-5 after he resigned from the Senate. The first period was a continuation of Lodge's longtime service as an Army Reserve officer. Lodge was a major in the 1st Armored Division. That tour ended in July 1942, when President Franklin D. Roosevelt ordered congressmen serving in the military to resign one of the 2 positions, and Lodge, who chose to remain in the Senate, was ordered by Secretary of War Henry Stimson to return to Washington. After returning to Washington and winning re-election in November 1942, Lodge went to observe Allied troops serving in Egypt and Libya, and in that position, he was on hand for the British retreat from Tobruk. Lodge served the first year of his new Senate term but then resigned his Senate seat on February 3, 1944 in order to return to active duty, the first U.S. Senator to do so since the Civil War. He saw action in Italy and France in the fall of 1944. Lodge single-handedly captured a 4-man German patrol at the end of the war. In 1945, he used his knowledge of the French language and culture, gained from attending school in Paris, to aid Jacob L. Devers, the commander of the 6th United States Army Group, to coordinate activities with the Army Group's 1st Army Commander, Jean de Lattre de Tassigny, and then carry out surrender negotiations with German forces in Western Austria. Lodge was decorated with the French Legion of Honor and Croix de Guerre with Palm. His American decorations included the Legion of Merit and the Bronze Star Medal. After the war, Lodge returned to Massachusetts and resumed his political career. He continued his status as an Army Reserve officer and rose to the rank of Major General. Return to Senate and the drafting of Eisenhower. In 1946, Lodge defeated Democratic Senator David I. Walsh and returned to the Senate. He soon emerged as a spokesman for the moderate, internationalist wing of the Republican Party. In late 1951, Lodge helped persuade General Dwight D. Eisenhower to run for the Republican presidential nomination. When Eisenhower finally consented, Lodge served as his campaign manager and played a key role in helping Eisenhower to win the nomination over Senator Robert A. Taft of Ohio, the candidate of the party conservative faction. In March 1950, Lodge sat on a subcommittee of the Government Operations Committee, chaired by Democratic Senator Millard Tidings, which looked into Senator Joseph McCarthy's list of possibly communist State Department employees. Lodge argued in hearings that Tidings demonized McCarthy and whitewashed McCarthy's supposed discovery of security leaks at the state Department Lodge told Tidings, "Mr. Chairman, this is the most unusual procedure I have seen in all the years I have been here. Why cannot the senator from Wisconsin get the normal treatment and be allowed to make his statement in his own way, and not be pulled to pieces before he has had a chance to offer one single consecutive sentence? I do not understand what kind of game is being played here." In July 1950, the record of the committee hearing was printed, and Lodge was outraged to find that 35 pages were not included. Lodge noted that his objections to the conduct of the hearing and his misgivings about the inadequacy of vetting suspected traitors were missing, and that the edited version read as if all committee members agreed that McCarthy was at fault and that there was no communist infiltration of the State Department. Lodge stated, "I shall not attempt to characterize these methods of leaving out of the printed text parts of the testimony and proceedings because I think they speak for themselves." Lodge soon fell out with McCarthy and joined the effort to reduce McCarthy's influence in the fall of 1952. Lodge found himself fighting in a tight race for re-election with John F. Kennedy, then a U.S. representative. His efforts in helping Eisenhower caused Lodge to neglect his own campaign. In addition, some of Taft's supporters in Massachusetts defected from Lodge to Kennedy campaign out of anger over Lodge's support of Eisenhower. In November 1952, Lodge was defeated by Kennedy. Lodge received 485% of the vote to Kennedy's 515%. It was neither the first nor the last time a Lodge faced a Kennedy in a Massachusetts election. In 1916, Henry Cabot Lodge had defeated Kennedy's grandfather John F. Fitzgerald for the same Senate seat, and Lodge's son, George, was defeated in his bid for the seat by Kennedy's brother Ted in the 1962 election for John F. Kennedy's unexpired term ambassador to United Nations. Lodge was named U.S. ambassador to the United Nations by President Eisenhower in February 1953, with his office elevated to cabinet-level rank in contrast to his grandfather, who had been a principal opponent of the UN's predecessor, the League of Nations. Lodge was supportive of the UN as an institution for promoting peace, as he famously said about it, "This organization is created to prevent you from going to hell. It isn't created to take you to heaven." Since then, no one has even approached his record of 7 years as ambassador to the UN during his time as UN ambassador. Lodge supported the Cold War policies of the Eisenhower administration, and often engaged in debates with the UN representatives of the Soviet Union during the CIA-sponsored overthrowing of the legitimate Guatemalan government. When Britain and France became concerned about the U.S. being involved in the aggression, Lodge, as U.S. ambassador to the United Nations, threatened to withdraw U.S. support to Britain on Egypt and Cyprus, and to France on Tunisia and Morocco, unless they backed the U.S. in their action. When the government was overthrown, the United Fruit Company re-established itself in Guatemala. The episodes tainted an otherwise distinguished career and painted Lodge as a face of U.S. imperialism and exceptionalism. In 1959, he escorted Soviet leader Nikita Khrushchev on a highly publicized tour of the United States 1960 vice presidential campaign. Lodge left the ambassadorship during the election of 1960 to run for vice president on the Republican ticket headed by Richard Nixon, against Lodge's old foe, John F. Kennedy. Before choosing Lodge, Nixon had also considered Philip Wilkie of Indiana, son of Wendell L. Wilkie, U.S. Representative Gerald Ford of Michigan, and U.S. Senator Thurston B. Morton of Kentucky. Nixon finally settled on Lodge in the mistaken hope that Lodge's presence on the ticket would force Kennedy to divert time and resources to securing his Massachusetts base, but Kennedy won his home state handily. Nixon also felt that the name Lodge had made for himself in the United Nations as a foreign policy expert would prove useful against the relatively inexperienced Kennedy. Nixon and Lodge lost the election in a razor-thin vote. The choice of Lodge proved to be questionable. He did not carry his home state for Nixon also. Some conservative Republicans charged that Lodge had cost the ticket votes, particularly in the South, by his pledge made without Nixon's approval that if elected, Nixon would name at least one African American to a cabinet post. He suggested Ralph Bunche as a wonderful idea. President John F. Kennedy meets with Director General of the Atlantic Institute, Henry Cabot Lodge, in the Oval Office, White House, Washington, D.C., 1961. Between 1961 and 1962, Lodge was the first Director General of the Atlantic Institute. Ambassador to South Vietnam. See also, XALOI Pagoda Raids, Cable 243, Krulik Mendenhall Mission, McNamara Taylor Mission, and Arrest and Assassination of Go Dinh Diem. Kennedy appointed Lodge to the position of ambassador to South Vietnam, which he held from 1963 to 1964. The new ambassador quickly determined that Ngô Đình Diệm, President of the Republic of Vietnam, was both inept and corrupt and that South Vietnam was headed for disaster unless Diệm reformed his administration or was replaced. While the coup toppled the Diệm government, it sparked a rapid succession of leaders in Vietnam, each unable to rally and unify their people and in turn overthrown by someone new. Removal of Diệm caused more political instability in the South, since no strong, centralized and permanent government was in place to govern the nation, not to mention an increase in Viet Minh infiltration into the southern populace and more attacks in the South after supporting the coup of President Diệm. Lodge then realized that the situation in the region deteriorated, and he suggested to the State Department that South Vietnam should be made to relinquish its independence and become a protectorate of the United States like the former status of the Philippines so as to bring governmental stability. The alternatives, he warned, were either increased military involvement by the U.S. or total abandonment of South Vietnam by America. Walking for president, Republican primaries results by state. Political amateurs working independently of the ambassador, who, believing they had little hope of winning him any delegates, did nothing to aid their efforts. However, when they scored the New Hampshire upset, Lodge, along with the press and Republican Party leaders, suddenly began to seriously consider his candidacy. Many observers remarked on the situation's similarity to 1952, when Eisenhower had unexpectedly defeated Senator Robert A. Taft, then leader of the Republican Party's conservative faction. However, Lodge, who refused to become an open candidate, did not fare as well in later primaries, and Goldwater ultimately won the presidential nomination. Later career, he was reappointed ambassador to South Vietnam by President Lyndon B. Johnson in 1965, and served thereafter as ambassador at large 1967-1968 and ambassador to West Germany 1968-1969. In 1969, when his former running mate Richard M. Nixon finally became president, he was appointed by President Nixon to serve as head of the American delegation at the Paris peace negotiations, and he served occasionally as personal representative of the president to the Holy See from 1970 to 1977. Personal life: Henry Cabot Lodge and family. In 1926, Lodge married Emily Esther Sears. They had two children, George Cabot Lodge II B. 1927 and Henry Sears Lodge B. 1930. George was in the Federal Civil Service and is now a well-published professor emeritus at Harvard Business School. Henry married Elenita Ziegler of New York City and is a former sales executive. In 1966 he was elected an honorary member of the Massachusetts Society of the Cincinnati. Lodge died in 1985 after a long illness and was interred in the Mount Auburn Cemetery in Cambridge, Massachusetts. 2 years after his death, Sears remarried Forrester A. Clark. She died in 1992 of lung cancer and is interred near her first husband in the Cabot Lodge family columbarium. See also World War II portal. List of United States political appointments that crossed party lines. References. Carrot. The Kennedys, End of a Dynasty. Life. 2009. Historical Society. MHS. Retrieved 24 December 2011. Navy Journal Incorporated. 1960 p. Carrot. Melvin Small. 1 June 1998. The Atlantic Council, The Early Years. PDF. NATO. United States Congress. David I. Walsh. Senator from Massachusetts. Class 1. 1947-1953. Served alongside Leverett. Saltonstall succeeded. U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations 1953-1960 succeeded. Ellsworth Bunker preceded. Class 1. Dalton Cabot. Goodhue. Mason Adams. Lloyd Gore. Ashmun. Mellon Mills. Webster. Choate. Webster. Winthrop. Rantoul. Sumner. Washburn. Dawes Lodge. Senior Butler. Walsh Lodge. J. Kennedy. Smith. E. Kennedy. Kirk Brown. Warren. Class 2. Strong. Sedgwick. Dexter. Foster. Pickering. Varnum. Otis Lloyd. Silsby. Davis. Bates. Davis. Everett. Rockwell. Wilson. Boutwell. Hoare. Crane. J. Weeks. Walsh. Gillett. Coolidge. Lodge. S. Weeks. Saltonstall. Brooks. Songas. Carey. Cowan. Markey. V.E. United States Republican Party Chairpersons of the RNC. Morgan. Raymond. Ward. Claflin. Morgan. Chandler. Cameron. Jewel. Sabin. Jones. Key. Clarkson. Carter. Hannah Payne. Cortelyou. New. Hitchcock. Hill. Rosewater. Hills. Wilcox. Hayes. Adams. Butler. Work. Houston. Fess. Sanders. Fletcher. Hamilton. Martin. Walsh. Spangler. Brownell. Reese. Scott. Gabrielson. Summerfield. Roberts. Hall. Alcorn. T.B. Morton. Miller. Birch. Bliss. R. Morton. Dole. Bush. Smith. Brock. Richards. Laxalt. Fahrenkopf. Reagan. Fahrenkopf. Atwater. Uter. Bond. Barber. Nicholson. Gilmore. Racicot. Gillespie Melman Martinez Duncan Steele Priebus Presidential tickets Fremont, Dayton Lincoln, Hamlin Lincoln, Johnson Grant, Colfax Grant, Wilson Hayes, Wheeler Garfield, Arthur Blaine, Logan Harrison, Morton Harrison, Reed McKinley, Hobart. McKinley, Roosevelt Roosevelt, Fairbanks Taft, Sherman, Butler Hughes, Fairbanks Harding, Coolidge Coolidge, Dawes Hoover, Curtis Twice Landon, Knox Wilkie, McNary Dewey, Bricker Dewey, Warren Eisenhower, Nixon Twice Nixon, Lodge Goldwater, Miller Nixon, Agnew Twice Ford, Dole Reagan, G.H.W. Bush Twice. G.H.W. Bush, Quayle Twice Dole, Kemp G.W. Bush, Cheney Twice McCain, Palin Romney, Ryan Trump, Pence Parties by State and Territory State Alabama Alaska Arizona Arkansas California Colorado Connecticut Delaware Florida Georgia Hawaii Idaho Illinois Indiana Iowa Kansas Kentucky Louisiana Maine Maryland Massachusetts Michigan Minnesota Mississippi Missouri Montana Nebraska Nevada, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New Mexico, New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Vermont. Virginia, Washington, West Virginia, Wisconsin, Wyoming, Territory, American Samoa, District of Columbia, Guam, Northern Mariana Islands, Puerto Rico, Virgin Islands, Conventions List 1856, Philadelphia, 1860, Chicago, 1864, Baltimore, 1868, Chicago. 1872 Philadelphia 1876 Cincinnati 1880 Chicago 1884 Chicago 1888 Chicago 1892 Minneapolis 1896 St. Louis 1900 Philadelphia 1904 Chicago 1908 Chicago 1912 Chicago 1916 Chicago 1920 Chicago 1924 Cleveland 1928 Kansas City 1932 Chicago 1936 Cleveland 1940 Philadelphia 1944 Chicago 1948 Philadelphia 1952 Chicago 1956 San Francisco 1960 Chicago 1964 San Francisco 1968 Miami Beach 1972 Miami Beach 1976 Kansas City 1980 Detroit 1984 Dallas 1988 New Orleans 1992 Houston 1996 San Diego 2000 Philadelphia 2004 New York 2008 St. Paul 2012 Tampa. 2016 Cleveland-affiliated organizations Fundraising groups National Republican Congressional Committee National Republican Senatorial Committee Republican Conference of the United States House of Representatives Republican Conference of the United States Senate Republican Governors Association Sectional groups College Republicans Chairman Congressional Hispanic Conference International Democrat Union Log Cabin Republicans Republican Jewish Coalition Republican National Hispanic Assembly Republicans Abroad Teenage Republicans Young Republicans Factional Groups Republican Main Street Partnership Republican Majority for Choice Republican Liberty Caucus Republican National Coalition for Life Republican Study Committee ConservAmerica Freedom Caucus Ripon Society The Wish List Related Articles History 2009 Chairmanship Election 2011 Chairmanship Election Bibliography Timeline of Modern American Conservatism Conservatism Portal VE United States Ambassadors to the United Nations Stettinius Austin Lodge Wadsworth Stevenson Goldberg Ball Wiggins Yost Bush Scully Moynihan Scranton Young McHenry Kirkpatrick Walters Pickering Perkins Albright Richardson Holbrook Negroponte Danforth Bolton Khalilzad Rice Power Haley Nominee VE United States Presidential Election, 1960 Democratic Party Convention Primaries Nominee John F. Kennedy VP Nominee Lyndon B. Johnson Candidates Ross Barnett Pat Brown Michael DeSalle Paul C. Fisher Hubert Humphrey Lyndon B. Johnson George H. McClain Robert B. Maynor Wayne Morse Albert S. Porter Adlai Stevenson George Smathers Stewart Symington Republican Party Convention Primaries Nominee Richard Nixon VP Nominee Henry Cabot Lodge Jr. Candidates Barry Goldwater Henry Cabot Lodge Jr. James M. Lloyd Nelson Rockefeller